Hey, how's it going, guys? Today I have the 2-in-1 iView Gemini tablet that's running a unique Remix OS 2.0 powered by Android. From the outside, this doesn't look like anything special. It has a plain gray color all around made from plastic, with the logo in the middle and the 2-megapixel rear and 0.3 front camera on top. The volume rockers and power button are on the top right, which are just a stretch away. On the right side is where you have the headphone jack, micro USB, micro HDMI, DC port, and a USB port on the bottom that can be used to plug in a mouse if you're not a fan of trackpads. Underneath, there's a reset button and a micro SD card slot along with 4 rubber bumpers on the bottom to prevent it sliding on a curved surface. Unfortunately, on paper it's not too powerful, being packed with an all-winter Cortex A53 CPU and a Mali 400 MP2, but it has 2 gigs of RAM, something you rarely see on a $100 tablet. It's running Android 5.1.1 with Remix OS 2.0 on top of it. This was my first time using it, and there were things I liked and disliked about it. The first is the home screen. I like the user interface because it gives more of a laptop feel to this hybrid, having the icons laid out this way and a taskbar on the bottom. The bottom left is similar to a start button on Windows where you can search for all your apps or shut down the tablet, a back button, your downloads, and then all the applications running. The apps that have a dot underneath show that it's running in the background. If you want to quit an app, then just hold the icon and bring it upwards. To pin an app, just drag the icon onto the taskbar. It's that simple. I found this to be a lot quicker to access and use than the traditional multi-window app tray on Android. On the right side of the taskbar, you can see how much RAM is being used and do a memory cleanup, Bluetooth, volume, brightness, keyboard, battery, and Wi-Fi buttons. Then there's a date and time, click on it, and a small calendar comes up. Finally, you have a notification tray at the end that has some more quick features. If you're in an application and want to go to the home screen, you can use 4 or 5 fingers to get there. You can make the home screen feel more like an Android device by adjusting the layout and settings and hiding the taskbar. I didn't really use this for much besides typing up a document, watching videos, or browsing the web. You can do all these things at the same time because some of the apps are optimized to open up in window mode, so you can have a video on one side and a file or document on the other. A lot of the games I tried wouldn't load, while others that did were slow and choppy. The only thing I did enjoy using was the Gameboy Emulator. This thing isn't suited for playing games. There's a little less than 10 gigs available for you to utilize and a micro SD card slot on the bottom, and you can store media files on it, but I'm not sure about being able to transfer applications. It's such a pain to put in and take out if you don't have long nails. This is a 2-in-1 tablet, and that means you're able to remove the tablet from the keyboard. However, it doesn't go on the other way because the magnets just repel. That's kind of a bummer because tent mode is my favorite position to watch a movie when I have it set on a table. To open it up, it takes a little more effort than usual and the latch is fairly strong, but it gets loose in my school bag after a while of walking around. It's a little heavy to carry around as a tablet, but lighter than your average laptop. Typing is easy on here if you've got small to mid-sized hands, and the trackpad on the bottom is responsive for the most part, which also has a right and left clicker. If you type quickly on here, then you'll notice a slight delay, as well as when you're backspacing too. It's a 10.1-inch IPS screen with a resolution of 1280 by 800. It doesn't get too bright or too dim, but you probably won't be able to use this outdoors. Watching videos at 720p is rather pleasant without having to worry about the uneven brightness on the screen when viewing at a certain angle, like with TFT screens. It's disappointing to know that you can't place this in tent mode or tablet mode like other 2-in-1s because the magnets just repel. The one thing that annoys me is how it can take up to 10 seconds for the lock screen to show up. I know this doesn't sound like a long time to some of you, but after a few seconds I would usually be close to restarting the tablet. It's kind of a hindrance as time goes by, so I would have to make the decision of keeping the screen time on longer. But then again, it really isn't a big problem since the battery life on here is pretty decent. On average, I can get a whole day out of this, which is around 5-6 hours of on-screen time. The thing is, I usually didn't spend time playing games or doing other heavy tasks. I mostly just use this in class to take notes and browse the web, which works almost flawlessly, except when it crashes. The one thing I hated is how many times the tablet shuts off on its own. It turns out that half the time it was because it runs out of battery, but other times it crashes when I'm trying to connect to Wi-Fi or something else. I was actually at 99% battery one time when it shut off on me, with the battery icon popping up saying that it needs to be recharged. Based on this, I knew for certain that there are some bugs with this tablet. If you're looking to do any kind of gaming on here, you definitely want to pass. For basic tasks and somewhat mild multitasking, this would be a decent choice as it has 2 gigs of RAM and a OS that's kind of utilized for it. I enjoyed trying Remix OS for the first time. It gave the 2-in-1 a more desktop-like feel while remaining simple and easy to understand. The bugs can be a nuisance on this thing, and if you're looking for a tablet that's faster to do more gaming on, but for around the same price as this, then check out the Viking 2 tablet. I'll have a link down below. Please leave a like if this video helps out, and as always, thanks for watching.